miss Mr. Andy Deck. Yeah, let's see what he has to say. Yay.
Brian Lucas, because he's feasting our feasting palate. And guess who I saw who now loves raw foods, Andy Deck?
Well, I was a raw foodist for a year, years ago. And I, like I was telling you, I vibrated on a whole other level. I had to stop because I wasn't communicating well.
Right, you're here and everybody else is down here.
Well,
you can't meet your match.
Yeah. I know. Here she is, finally. I met my match.
When anybody's eating a papaya, I can't help but be attracted to them.
Brian Lucas makes the best papaya.
He picks it anywhere, you know. But what do you love about raw foods? Why are you going back to it?
It's because I feel high and I don't have to take drugs or drink.
Right, exactly. And you have to maintain your energy and your weight. Right, exactly.
Well, I'm trying to get back to my ideal weight. You gotta be quiet, there's a hippie on stage.
Actually, Andy and I met on the Kimmel show. I was going in, he was going out. Were you raw then?
No.
How do you find it affects your creativity and acting? Your mind is so clear, right?
I have been writing poetry, I've been writing songs. They're not gonna hear this because
we
don't have
closer.
A mic back there. Yeah. You should come over here. Not on a dolly. You don't have to be a dolly. Come right up here.
Yeah. So what does it do for your creativity?
It popped. Everything, my brain, I meditate now. I didn't even want to meditate, but I crave to meditate. And while I'm meditating, I have to keep stopping.
Right,
I have songs coming out, poems, short stories.
It's like flowing out of you, like the river.
Like I can't stop it.
Right.
We become like an empty vessel for something else to work through us, you know.
Right. What I have found for me is raw foods, exercise, and expression. And I feel whole and complete.
Yeah. My girl here, Wendy, told me to write. And she's the one that encouraged me to write, and it's really been helping me. It's been helping my... You know, my brain, I'm a little nuts.
You're not nuts. You're sane in a nutty world.
I think so.
That's the
thank
problem.
You.
We all think
thank
we're nuts, but we're the same ones.
Yeah, it settles me. It settles my mind when I write.
Right.
So.
I was saying it's called write things right. And when you write, you know. And you know what you didn't know. And now he's having a date. He'd rather that than me. I've offered to take him out tonight.
Uh-huh.
Why didn't you eat the papaya seeds?
You
kill bacteria and parasites?
I know. I put them in my... They're bitter. I put them in my smoothie, but only like one teaspoon.
Oh, these are like the most expensive jewels. These are like the diamonds of Van Cleef & Arpels of the papaya. You gotta save these.
Well, and I'm glad you told me that because I used to put them in and I stopped because they're so bitter.
No, they kill parasites. Everybody's got parasites. I'm gonna eat with my hands like all good Italians do. But just go ahead.
You're Italian? But they're bitter, you know that. Don't lie.
Yeah, but see, the only way to heal is by acquiring a taste for bitter food. That means green leaves, papaya seeds, sauerkraut, all the alkaline foods. Alkaline destroys cancer. It's a killer of disease. The more alkaline you are, the less disease you have. And disease,
you don't want to be acidic.
Acidic is cancerous, and that's why...
I wish my son was here. You should hear this. Come here, we're on camera.
Come on over. We're over. Look at how handsome he is.
He's more handsome.
He does not look like he has a son.
No,
he doesn't. Look at what raw foods has done for this guy in 4 months. He's just produced this 5'9", gorgeous, young, darling, handsome man. What's your name?
Lucas.
Oh, you have a Lucas here and a Lucas there.
Oh, sorry.
And a Wendy here. Are you a writer?
She's a painter.
Oh, painter. Wait, you can't go off camera like that. You have to exit first. Tell us what you like about them.
Which was the black blue? I like the nuts. The nuts are pretty good. It just makes you feel good.
It gives you so much energy. He's been eating like all the nuts. I tell him, for every little bit of nuts, you got to eat a lot of greens.
Oh, greens. Because you know what, Andy? There's a saying, too. We get nutty on nuts and fruity on fruit. We all need to have a green party and invite ourselves to it.
He doesn't want to hear about it.
You got to eat more greens.
Away because he's 18.
Yeah, but when I was 18, I was, in Miami living up the good life.
You walked away from the part you need to hear.
What the hell? How did you just throw that out? I don't know.
We get nutty on nuts and fruity on fruits. It's good to have a green party and invite ourselves to it. Because the green helps digest the nuts. And one of the problems,
lock yourself up.
I had bad acne when I ate a lot of nuts, and it wasn't eliminating properly, and I was feeling heavy and tired. If you can't run around the block after a meal, then what you ate isn't good. If you can't feel like acting or writing or dancing, then what you ate didn't do the thing for you.
Uh-huh.
So please stay raw and help America get healthy. ladies are doing it. It's working, guys. You know,
I'm coming on your show. Just spread
he's coming on the show. He's going to become a chef. Before then, he'll bring his favorite dish. What do you like to make?